I thought love was just something idiots thought they felt, but this woman has a hold on my heart that I could not break if I wanted to. And there have been times that I wanted to. It has been overwhelming and humbling and even painful at times. But I could not stop loving her any more than I could stop breathing. I am hopelessly, irretrievably in love with her. More than she knows.
So I'm filming with a GoPro, and it's cool because I can't see how ugly I look, and I kind of like it. So this is me. I'm out skating real quick. My horrible sock combination, but it's something. And it's mine. I'm on this huge road that probably is not meant to be skated on, but I'm doing it anyways. So hey, we've been here before. Yeah, it's pretty nice, eh? This is kind of my go-to spot for just coming to sit and think. It's not that private, like it's easy to get into. You just have to pass a no trespassing sign, but it's nice. So lately I haven't been feeling too amazing or happy, which sucks. 2 weeks ago, I was the happiest kid that you could find. I was so happy. Now, today, I want to talk about distance. It's about everything. Everything distance-wise, I'm just, oh my God, I hate it. I hate distance. I hate it. I hate the distance you have to travel to find your happiness. I hate the distance you have to travel to feel comfortable at home. I just hate distance. I mean, think about it. My best friend doesn't even live near me. You know, everybody grew up with those best friends where you can walk down the street, knock on their door. They go out, they go skating with you. You know, I didn't have that. And now my best friend lives, God knows where he lives. I have no idea where he is right now. I think he's in LA. I mean, I miss the distance that I'm away when I miss my family. I miss that a lot. I hate the distance from the person that I love. That's the big one right now, which sucks. I'm just not happy with it. I feel alone. And I don't expect anybody to comment or anything. I'm not going for an answer. I'm not going for pity. I'm just going to just share my opinion. I share it online and that's what I do. So I'm doing it again. I don't know. I feel alone. I stopped looking at places in Toronto. And if you know me, you know I want to move there because I just got let down. I gave up. And the other thing is that from past events, I'm not really encouraged to live alone or be alone in any matter like now. But sometimes it's just nice to be alone and get some alone time. But being alone for me isn't very good. I had a plan to go see somebody this weekend, which I don't know when you're watching this, but yeah. And it fell through, you know, and it wasn't my fault. It was Mother Nature's fault. My flight got canceled. Everything got canceled. And then I had a plan for the next month to go see the person, and it got canceled. That's awesome. I like to share all this stuff with you guys because I don't know if you guys are going through anything like this or anything even similar to it or remotely similar to it. But I like to share my opinion because maybe you are going through something and I want you to know that you're not alone, even though I feel so damn alone right now. I don't know if you've ever felt this, but when you wake up and you just want to feel somebody, not even in a sexual way at all, just to feel their presence. There's a difference between talking to somebody and being able to feel yourself talking to somebody. There's a whole different feeling that comes with talking to somebody in person, and I miss it. I miss it a lot. I find myself not being able to necessarily translate through text or through FaceTime or through phone call and stuff like that, everything like that. It's just, there's something so different about being with somebody. That's through a text to my mom, through a text to my best friend, to a text to anyone. You, to a text to you. I know you're watching. It just sucks, you know? I think I'm just gonna end it here with this last thing. And then I just wanna put this up just to get it off my chest. I wanna go home. And as beautiful as Ottawa is and Greeley is and everything and being home with my mom, it's not home anymore. I don't feel at home here. And I wanna go home. Hopefully I can go home sometime soon. Stay you, stay beautiful, and I'll update you guys a little bit later.